What's up, everyone, and welcome to Sunday with Ola number 27. So what's up, you beautiful people? Huh? Are you guys good? I'm okay. I'm actually really, really okay. Thank you so much for asking. You didn't ask, but thank you. Appreciate it. So, we're gonna start out really hot in this one, okay? We at Solar Guitars released 4 new guitars this past Friday with Fishman Fluence pickups. I mean, maybe you've seen that we're releasing more and more guitars with Fishman Fluence pickups. Well, yes, we've been pushing it a little bit. I like the Fishman Fluence, so that's why. So go check them out, there's a video somewhere in the stratosphere, but we're gonna check out the news. Okay, so I'm really late to the party regarding this one, but I wanted to talk a little bit about the new... Is it new? The Gibson Adam Jones of Tool, you know, Adam Jones, the guitar player of Tool. Gibson has released a set of custom shop guitars with his name on it. They're called the Adam Jones 1979 Les Paul Custom Aged and Signed Antique Silverburst. So, this limited edition Gibson custom shop model exactly replicates Adam's number one guitar, his prized original Silverburst 1979 Gibson Les Paul Custom. The finish has been expertly aged and duplicates the original guitar, as do all the other details, right down to a mounted replica of his headstock mirror and the included custom Adam Jones hard shell case. Only 79 of these guitars, personally hand signed and numbered by Adam, will be built by the expert luthiers and craftspeople of the Gibson custom shop. Okay, so there's a mirror on the headstock. That's cool. I wonder what that's for. Oh, is that for, you know, when you have stage lights going onto the headstock, it will bounce off? That's actually not a bad idea. I like that. Okay, so that mirror is probably like, you know, worth a lot of money. The price of this thing, this aged one, is 10 grand. One can argue about the price being a little bit too high, but I mean, it's Gibson. Okay, even the screws are a little bit rusty there, can you see that? And there's also some shit there on the pickup. Is that like finger shit? Look at that, look at those pickups, man. They're all rusty and shit. And then there's a little expertly relicked thing there by the next to the pickup that looks expertly made. What? It's expertly made. That's what I wanted to say. So yeah, man, you got a crack right there. Expertly made crack. That's cool. I mean, okay, I think it looks like a sick guitar. Now, worth 10 grand? I'm not so sure, but what really surprises me is that they're making 79 of them and they're 10 grand each, okay? And they're out of stock, so they're all sold out. My question is now, I mean, fine, I love Tool, and Tool is a great band and they have a lot of fans out there, but even though they have a lot of fans, I have a really hard time imagining 79 people having the money to buy something like this. Like, who is this guitar made for? The Tool fan? I just don't know. Is that a thing that Tool fans are really, you know, rich or something? It's just a shit ton of money, man. I don't know if they're like building it with, you know, unicorn powder or whatever, and, you know, made by elves in the factory or whatever. Whatever makes it worth this much. But yeah, it is Gibson. You know, they do have wicked prices on their guitar, so it's understandable, but I'm just really, really surprised that it's out of stock and that they sold all 79 of them. That's insane. All I can say is fucking congratulations, that's amazing right there. So that's the Adam Jones signature guitar right there. Unfortunately, I have another piece of news regarding this that is not as awesome. I'm laughing, but it's just because it's a great piece of news. It's another article from Guitar World where it says 95k worth of Gibson Adam Jones 1979 Les Paul Customs stolen in a premeditated theft. 13 of the Tool's guitars just announced signature models were taken from a Sweetwater truck. Now, an entire pallet of newly released Gibson Adam Jones 1979 Les Paul custom electric guitars has been stolen. The pallet containing 13 guitars was taken from a Sweetwater music truck at the Flying J Travel Center in Whiteland, Indiana on October 30th. Gibson and Sweetwater believe the theft was planned in advance because one pallet was singled out of all the guitars. And this made me think, I mean, obviously, because they're worth a lot of money, it would make a lot of sense for a thief to steal these guitars because they're, you know, they're really expensive, and he got 13 of them. But I'm still a little, you know, shocked to hear that they've sold 79 of them. Maybe I'm on a conspiracy theory thought right here, but what if this is a setup somehow? Maybe this is fake news. Maybe Gibson stole their own guitars. Why? Maybe they didn't sell all of them? I don't know. Maybe they just want the news? Because now they're in the news, and when it's on Sunday with Ola News, it matters. So, fake news or not, I have no idea. It's incredibly sad though, I'm gonna give him that. I mean, no one likes a thief. Don't be a thief, that sucks, okay? So there you go, that's a little a great piece of news right there. Okay, another piece of news that I have is that there's a new band out there. It's a super group, it's Grand Cadaver, Ex Catatonia, Dark Tranquility. They just released, and is it an EP or they're releasing? They just dropped a single. It's this new supergroup of Swedish Swedish musicians from various bands. And this single right here, it's nasty as fuck. If you like HM2 and just like sick stuff, it's the fucking shit right there. This is completely up my alley. I love this stuff. They're releasing an EP called Madness Comes. No, Madness, just Madness. It comes in February 2021. So that's cool. I'm looking forward to this actually. So there you go, Grand Cadaver. That's cool.
Who's up there? You won't escape that way.
So a couple weeks back, I saw an Instagram post from Gary Holt, guitar player of Exodus and also Slayer. He was selling a Dimebag tribute guitar. Now, I'm usually just interested in Washburn Dimebag guitars, but Gary was selling a somewhat cool Dimebag tribute guitar made by a guy called Tom Smith, and I thought it was a sick ass looking guitar. So I bought it from Gary, even though he wouldn't ship it overseas for people. He did it for me. That's very nice of him. Thank you so much, Gary. Anyways, I'm gonna unbox it today. It came like this. Oh shit. Careful. You would think that I've opened so many boxes throughout my lifetime that I would know how to open a guitar box, but well, shit, here it is. All right, let's check it out. Ooh, shit, that looks amazing. Are you guys ready for this? Holy fuck. Look at that, man. Are you guys seeing this? Look at this. Isn't that fucking sick? Yeah, man, I mean, shit, like really, shit. It looks insane. Looks a lot better than on the picture, in my opinion. I guess the backside is mahogany, maple neck with something rosewood or jatoba stripes right there. This, I guess, is a poplar burl top right there. But look at this, man. Calvers from L emblem right there. Dimebag's face on that one. Look at that. It has the Gary Holt EMG signature set, I imagine, which is an 81 EMG and an 89. I think it's an 89. Schaller floating trem right there. This is probably an ebony fretboard. It looks great. So Tom Smith, who built this guitar, he's a small builder that built Gary one or two guitars. He had this done when Gary came along and he finished it up for Gary. And Gary had his guitar guy, you know, finish it all off, putting in, you know, the EMGs, doing the frets and all that. And see that inlay? Razor blade inlay. It's in tune. It's been shipped all the way from California and it's in tune. That's a good sign right there. Holy shit, I can't wait to try this out. That top right there looks absolutely gorgeous. Holy shit. All I'm gonna go and play it. And the Sunday with Ola. And here it is. Look at that. It's fucking badass. So, at first I was trying to plan and make like a my guitar video for this guitar. But the thing is that this guitar came completely set up by Gary Holt's guitar guy. And it's already been done. There's not really anything to do. I mean, the strings are new. I'm not going to change the strings and then do a resetup on a guitar that was just recently set up by a pro setup guy. How many times did I say setup? Okay. Let's plug it in, baby. Okay. Let's try this out. There's basically no output of this thing. Okay, let me check the battery real quick. Hello! I don't know how to open this. Maybe it's a weak battery. I can't get the battery out. Feel like a fucking moron. Oh well, okay, great. Well, so I have a dead battery. It's like the output is really low. But it feels really good to play, man. You just have to imagine it sounding really, really awesome and that these pickups sound really awesome. But right now... Yeah, man, it feels great. I wish I could take out the battery, but it's stuck in there. How do I unstuck it? Anyways, so there you go. That's my new little guitar right there. I think it's fucking incredible. Look at that. Look at that fucking thing right there. Holy shit. Flexing with Ola, thank you. Okay, so send Ola shit. I have to make an intro for that. So I got a little message. It's really nice. I'm getting all these handwritten letters from people, and you know, it's nice. I never, like, how long ago did I get like a handwritten letter? Before I started doing this, I don't even remember, but it's really cool. I'm getting letters right now. This letter says, "Hey Ola, my name is Corey LeBlanc. I've been watching your channel for some time and love it. You rock. I have been playing guitar for 10 years off and on, but your videos have inspired me to get better. I have a Jackson Dinky and love it. Hopefully one day I can buy a Dean from Hell or one of your guitar one day. I'm a big Dimebag fan. I have been playing his stuff for a while now. Just wanted to send you this gift that I airbrushed for your birthday and to say thanks for your videos. Your friend Corey LeBlanc." Holy shit, man. Thank you so much. That's really nice, man. I mean, hearing that I inspire people to play guitar, I just don't know what to say. Like, it's so weird to hear that, but thank you so much, I appreciate it. So he sent me this, which is, let me get closer to the camera. Okay. It's I guess it's like a water or thermos. Is that what you call it? A thermos? Thermos? With the Old England logo on it, and then on the other side, you have Dimebag. Isn't that cool? I think that's really awesome. Fucking hell, man, that's great. Thank you so much. That smells like, insides of a thermos. Thank you so much, Corey. I really, really appreciate that. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. All right, so every Sunday, and with every Sunday with Ola, I'm doing these riff challenges, right? Where I just write a piece of music with drums. I challenge myself to write something every week. And then I put that in the intro of the Sunday with Ola videos, and I'm letting you guys download the drums from that song, and you can make your own riffs, and you can upload that to YouTube, and I might feature you in the upcoming Sunday with Olas. Now we're gonna check out a couple from last week's Sunday with Ola riff challenge, and we're starting right here with Need More Blast Beats. HM2. Yeah, man. This is the Swedish death metal green right here. That's how you look badass. Classic, man. Sounds like old Entombed and Dismember. Even the melody lines sound Swedish. F***ing hell yeah, brother! Need more blast beats. Well done, buddy. Next up, Melissa Avila. What? Look at that face. We have the same face now. Like the lip face? Very Lamb of God-ish, I love this. I can hear voices on this, you know. Oof. Skull on fire! Skulls on fire! Skulls! Yeah, that was amazing. Awesome. Melissa, thank you so much. That made me happy. All right, then we have Arnold plays guitar. Let's go. Oh, all these sponsors. Okay. Shit, a lot of sponsors. Ugh. Disgusting. Yes, some Gojira kick scraping. I like it. Oh, he has the IKEA Frederick studio setup. That's okay, I had that. That's a great fucking desk right there for a good price. And these are some nasty ass riffs, man. Oh, melodies. Yeah, man. That's great. Arnold! You bastard, that was excellent, thank you. Now, Arnold has a YouTube channel, Arnold Plays Guitars, and I'll put the links to all these guys in the description of the video so you can go check them out and, you know, give them a thumbs up. You can even subscribe to their channels. But Arnold Plays Guitars has a great guitar-related YouTube channel that I urge you to go check out and subscribe to. I think he's incredible. He's an incredible person as well. Very, very nice. Okay, good. If you want to be a part of Sunday with Ola Riff Challenge, download the drums in the description of this video, upload and write your own riffs, upload it to YouTube. I might see you in the next Sunday with Ola.
Ola Tasting Shit.
What's up, everyone? Welcome to Ola Tasting Shit. Today, we have a lot of shit to try out. My good member, my little member, Jack Fisher, he and his wife prepared a huge box this size of stuff for us to eat.
And it was fully packed like a Tetris.
It was fully packed, and there's just so much stuff here. This is not all of it. He also made a list, because everything on these packages are in Hebrew. How good is your Hebrew, Luis?
I don't know.
I don't even know what's up or down. So I'm just looking at the characters to decide, okay, this is the right way to hold this. A lot of potato chips, a lot of stuff, actually. I mean, where the hell do we begin? So should we just start? Where's number one?
I don't know if number one was here. There's so many.
There's two here.
One. Warning.
Okay, so we have number one here. It's potato chips. Tapu chips, crunchy natural flavor. These are regular potato chips.
Yeah.
Okay, so I guess they're potato chips. Everything here is kosher, by the way.
That's great.
That is great. Good shit. You know, I think this is... Isn't this like Ole's? Like the Ole brand? But probably in like a Hebrew version. Sour cream and onion. My favorite. Oh, it says onion and sour cream.
Yeah. You know, we need to, like, do it quickly, because it's so much.
There's so much, but we're going through the crisps right now, or chips.
What does it say?
Barbecue flavor.
Yeah. Nice.
I mean, isn't this the best time ever? You're sitting and eating chips, and it's actually... It's working hours. That's what I'm happy
this
about.
This is our job.
This is my job right here. I'm sitting here eating chips. from all across the world. Herb flavor. Okay, now we're gonna open these. Look at that. So this Dubonim, as you can tell, Dubonim means little bears in Hebrew. Not little bears, little bears in Hebrew. They actually are little bears. But this one has a face in the belly as well. Let me out! Let me out!
This one is happy.
This doesn't have any flavor.
This one has no flavor either.
A little bit of flavor, yeah. I like the chips better than the small little bears. I'm sorry, small little bears.
I think maybe these are more for the kids. Four or five. Oh yeah, we missed it. Mm-hmm. You wanna do?
I wanna do.
You wanna do?
I wanna do.
You wanna do?
Small like porfritos, like we say in Sweden. Porfritos.
Homme.
Homme. Tastes great. Kefli means I'm having fun in Hebrew. Oh. Are we? We're having fun.
Yes. This is,
it's like, you know, these balls. I love balls.
Those were actually nice.
They're like ostbåge,
a little bit, without
the cheese.
And without the båge, it's just a ball.
Okay, onion flavored, same thing. We're having fun in Hebrew. I'm having so much fun in Hebrew right now.
Can you say one word in Hebrew?
Kosher.
Okay. Doesn't taste much.
No.
Bit butter.
It has a salt thing here. Maybe you need to add salt.
And butter.
And butter. Screws. Screw my screw face right there. All the screws. These look like,
it looks like
cereal.
Full corn.
Oh, full, yeah.
Like whole grain.
This visli right here translates to bite me.
Yeah.
Or I'm having a bite. Yeah. Scratch my dick.
So bad you can't read it.
Sort of wish I knew how to read Hebrew now. But I can't. Look at that. It's like dog treats.
Oh. It's also hard.
Falafel?
Yeah.
Ach, Shelly Beastly, Bisless brother. Ach means brother in Hebrew. Falafel flavored consonant.
We know a Hebrew word. Ach.
Ach, Shelly Beastly.
Ach, Shelly Beastly.
There it is.
What's the red thing?
That's Beastly, the brother.
The bald brother.
I think we have to take a break. We're not going to be able to eat all of this today. Okay, hola tasting shit. We're going to continue on this adventure in Hebrew, kosher style, next week. See ya. And that, my friends, is the end of this Sunday with Ola. Thank you so much for watching. And I also want to, you know, reach out to my beautiful members. Thank you so much for being awesome. And guys, premiere chat. Who was the winner last time? Last week's winner was Oiled with the comment, I like guitars. And we also had Evil Gimp, Get Matt Laid before that. Suck My Little Penis by Mike Owens. F Word by Ray Hernandez. And Scientology for the Win by Marty. Great! You can be the winner of this week's Premier Chat. You just have to stick around and be the last guy running a comment. How about that? Okay, guys. Thank you so much for watching. See you next Sunday. All right, my friends.